Morning guys, welcome to Ammo Trucking Life 79. It's only bloody Friday. Just about though, 1 o'clock in the morning again. Just getting ready to go out. I've got to sort out my wires from yesterday, my Susie's, so you want to come with me or what? Let's get the air building up as well, not that he's lost any. Oh dear. Hope you all slept well. Most of you are still asleep now, actually. Oh dear. I've been putting my gloves in there because they start to stink the place out when they get hot. All the lights are nice and shining. Probably the first week I've done for these guys where I've been away all week. Normally I've had a chance to get back and give the truck a wash. But not this week. So we're running solo down to Telford. We're not going to straight to the yard, we've got to pick up a trailer on the way. So we've got about 80 odd miles to go. Solo trip, that's pretty cool. I'm sure no one's been fucking around with the trailer. The unit, sorry. Yeah, she's gonna need a wash today if I get a chance. Hopefully, I ain't gonna be rushed off my feet today. And everything looks pretty good. So we're all good to go. I'm not gonna bore you with the massive time lapse again today, so we'll just see how the video goes. I'm gonna do a control freak video again, driving the Scania. So I'm gonna work on that now before we hit the motorway. I'll speak to you in a bit. Okay guys, let's get out of here. Yeah. Let's go. We're leaving Warrington from the safety of my little quiet road. Managed to gain four trucks company. That was news to me. I didn't even hear them come. Never mind. That's where I dropped the trailer last night. On that last bay over there. But I got disturbed twice. Actually, you could say three times. I got woke up by a trucker after somewhere. One of our guys. He came to the right postcode and everything, but couldn't find the place, and I didn't know the place either, unfortunately. So I couldn't help him. So then I was just getting myself off settled, just starting to go off to sleep, and then it was another horn outside. Another one of our guys. It was the guy who'd come to get my trailer. And they hadn't told him that the trailer was inside the depot. So he was asking where my trailer was, so he woke me up as well. And then it was about another 25 minutes later, I had another call off the transport asking if the guys come to pick the trailer up. And then I was reminding him about me not having a trailer. So he says, oh, I'll get back to you now because you haven't got a trailer. But we're sorted. We're still good to go to our original place in Telford. And we'll pick up the loaded trailer, take that back to base, pick up an empty trailer, take that up for them to load, and then come back down and pick another trailer up for them to leave empty when they've loaded the trailer I took up first. If you get my drift. So we just got to head up here now to the M6. The sat nav wanted me to go a longer way. It was a more direct way that saved having to go up and back down on myself, but it's 1 o'clock in the morning, there's no traffic, and I don't want to drive through little villages at this time of night. Although saying that, I'll be going down the A49, so there's plenty of villages there I'll be whizzing through. Not to worry. So let's get this done. Let's get Friday over with and let's get home, eh? Well, we got a bit of a development. They've only got a few pallets ready. So they've cancelled the 3 o'clock collection. So now that's given me the chance to go back to the yard and pick up an empty trailer and take it back up there. They should have a load ready for 6 o'clock instead now. So it's only about 15 minutes between each place. So I'm gonna go pick up my empty trailer and take that down. And then it's just a case of doing the trailer swap when the trailer's ready. I don't know how many they're doing a day, but my name's down for doing them all, so we shall see how long it's gonna take. Hopefully there isn't too many, because I'm really looking forward to getting home tonight, or this afternoon hopefully. It's been a really testing week. Maybe it's because I was so far away, but I don't know. I've just really struggled this week. It's always hard, don't get me wrong, but this week's just been a lot harder, especially yesterday when I thought I was going to be getting a lot closer to home, to have to stop up there. Kind of gutted me a bit. But so let me know, guys, what have you got planned for the weekend? We ain't got nothing major planned. We've got to finish off a few bits of Christmas shopping. Not much else, really. But I just can't wait. Can't wait to be back. Oh well, I've got my trailer now. It took a little longer than I thought because I had to diesel up. So, never mind, it's 5 to 5 now. So, by the time I get over there and drop the trailer, shouldn't be too long a wait for the first load to be pulled out. Come on, let's get this Friday done. Oh, what have you done, Chris? I've pulled the trailer off the bay and as I was just shunting it up, I normally press the shunt button, but this time, because it was on a hill, I decided to connect the red air line up just in case. So I've done that, pulled the trailer off the bay, and then when I've dropped the trailer, I've totally forgot to bloody pull the red air line off, so I've snapped the red air line. Fortunately, I'm running around the corner from the yard. Oh, I'm really pissed off at myself for that. Stupid error. I've never done it before, and I'm really gutted now. I'm just waiting for someone to come out and fix me a new one on there. This is just what I wanted. Oh dear. I'll have to face the music when I get back to the yard. Everyone's done it, I guess. It's a bit of a rookie mistake, but people that have been driving 30 odd years still occasionally do it, so. I'm just really gutted that I've done it now, pissed off. Once they've done that, I'll get back on the road, get the trailer back on the bay, take this one back to the yard, and then I presume I'll be bringing another empty back up, and this time I won't be breaking any red air lines. Alright, well, I'm back over at Donington. No issues this time when I've changed the trailers around. I've made sure I was fully concentrating. I'm still really pissed off that I did that though. So apparently the next trail is not going to be ready till about 10 o'clock, so I'm going to have to wait. And the guy mentioned on the phone that there's like one at 10 o'clock, one at 1 o'clock and one at 3 o'clock. So I had to remind him that I started at 1 o'clock this morning, so I can't imagine me getting many more done after this one. We did have to wait because the one was cancelled this morning because they didn't have enough, and the guy said it's a bit of a slow day today, so I don't know, maybe they'll cancel the 10 o'clock and just have a 1 o'clock. I don't know, maybe it works, but we'll see. So yes, sun's coming out now, it's brightening up a bit, and I'm just gonna wait now for the trailer to be ready again. Hello again. I parked up, had my fag, and then got on the bunk for a bit, expecting a bit of a wait. And then I had a call about 10 to 9 saying that they've cancelled the next three loads, so there was no more trailer swapping to be done. And I just got to hang on, because there might have been a load further around the corner for me to get. So I've hanged on. Now I've just had the all clear to get myself done. So I've got to trundle on back to the yard now. It's only about 10-15 minutes. Get the truck dieseled up and fueled up, ready for the next guy. Get all my gear out and get home. Oh, can't wait. Oh dear. I want to say hello to, I finally got an email off YouTube to tell me of my subscribers. Now it hasn't backdated it, so I want to welcome Andrew Shortland to the channel. Thank you for subscribing, I hope you enjoy your stay. I'll re-welcome the last four or five that subbed. I haven't got your name, so if you do want to, just drop me a comment and I'll give you a shout out in the forthcoming videos. Other than that, I hope you all have a lovely weekend. And I'll see you on Monday. Goodbye.